At times, full-time truck camping can bring up many opportunities for being pushed out of my comfort zone. This is one of those times.
I just booked a naked hip camp.
In this video, I stay at my first clothing optional campsite.
I'm 59 years old, I have scars.
As a novice, I end up breaking several rules. Will I chicken out or get kicked out?
I just booked a naked hip camp.
If you don't know, hip camp is like Airbnb for campsites. Hosts with private land rent it out to campers. This is my first day with Hipcamp, and this campsite had full hookups, and it was $45 a night.
I needed a place with electric and sewer dump and water, and this came up, so why not go into a naked Hipcamp? Right. Driving up now. They said you needed 4x4. I'm a 4x2. I'm not 4x4, but hopefully it looks like I can make it. Okay, got this bad boy in tow haul. Let's do it. Made it to the naked hip camp.
Can you guess how many times I say naked in this video? I could have said nude, unclothed, sans clothing, etc., but I chose to say naked many, many times. I give the final count at the end. So far, naked count is 7.
I'm the only one here. The owner said that this is the first weekend that they're not booked up. So I don't know why. It's still pretty hot out there, and I guess I'm going to the hot tub naked. But he said he's going to be out here naked, so maybe I won't be the only person naked. Who cares? It is a beautiful property. I'll take you around. There's hiking trails, there's a hot tub. He said that he just drained the swimming pool for the season because it is October, but it is still super hot out there. The owner said they're going out to dinner later, so then I'll probably take the camera around, but I should probably tell them that I'm vlogging. And I'm not getting anyone else naked, not even me. No, I'm not going naked in the vlog. If I will, okay.
I made two big mistakes. I forgot to tell the host I was vlogging, and I didn't read the rules until after I left. Rule number 2, photography or videography is not permitted. Okay, this should have been like a duh moment for me, really, because people are naked. Of course you don't want to be taking pictures. Maybe because I'm a newbie, or I'm naive, or both. Look, it really didn't dawn on me. And look at number 7. Okay, this rule says it all. This is not that kind of place. It's just for people who want to be free from the confines of clothing, and that is it. Okay, moving on.
I feel kind of funny. I'm naked and I'm gonna walk out in the hot tub. Okay, here I go. I actually have to walk there. I'm 59 years old. I have scars. Like, I'm walking outside naked. All right, we're doing this. I'm doing this. I'll let you know how it goes. Probably uneventful. There's no one else here. I don't know. Somehow I would feel more comfortable if there was other people here, you know? I don't know. When everybody's naked, you don't feel naked. But if you're the only one naked, you feel naked. This is lovely. I'm sitting outside having a snack. It's a pretty big snack. I think it might turn out to be my dinner. So nice. This property is so beautiful. I was the only one in the hot tub. The owner came by and it's really nice. He was like asking me if I needed anything. They were going to Walmart and Home Depot. So that was really sweet that he asked. I really don't. I'm here eating my snack. Green olives are so good. I'm really enjoying this. Being naked outside is pretty freeing. Like, I don't know. I don't have any naked friends, though. I'm the only one here, besides, the host couple. Okay.
There's hiking trails here. There's no way I'm hiking naked. There's a deer. I see a deer. I'm gonna try to get him. It's a small deer. I don't want the dogs to see him. They'll start barking. Or her. She ran away. How pretty, though. Little white tail flickering. So this area I think is for tent camping. And there's my camper. And there's another RV spot right to my camper. It's a pull-through spot. So you can probably fit a bigger camper in here than you can in the spot I'm in. That's a back-end spot. They said 30 feet or less. And I'm definitely a less. They have a bus that you can rent. They call it the Jesus bus, seeking God, loving people. I'd love to see inside. I know there's pictures of it on their website. Very comfy. And then there's the bathroom. It's an A-frame bathroom. So it's a full bathroom and shower. Probably be using that shower later. Very cute. Also, two outdoor showers. I like these canoes with plants in them. It's Ron and Lilo. I'm gonna take them inside and feed them and come out and watch the sunset. So I lost my sunset shots, but here are pictures from their website. It looked just like that. Very beautiful. The following day, I woke up before sunrise to enjoy the hot tub one more time. It was serene. With only nature sounds accompanying the bubbles. Beautiful morning, so nice.
dogs are still sleeping. Good morning. Good morning, Miss Lilo. Hi, sweetheart. Good boy, Ron. Ron wants to go out. He does. You want to go out, Ron? I have to take them for a walk. I put on a bathrobe to take them out for a walk because it's a little chilly this morning. Chilly this morning for a naked dog walk, but I might just do it because whenever am I gonna do a naked dog walk outside? Like, yeah, if I'm up for the experience, so naked dog walk it is. Picking up poo naked. Okay, naked dog walk it is. This is wild, but it's fun. It's different, right? You gotta keep life different. Like when you're in like a boring cycle, your life goes so fast. And when you add novelty and fun and interesting things, different things into your life slows down. Like you're a child just discovering things all over again. I'm discovering being naked outside. Walking my dogs.
I'm not saying you have to go naked to shake up your life. Just do something that makes you uncomfortable or that you think is exciting. Like give that speech, take that trip, write that poem, whatever it is for you.
Naked dog walk, new different experience. Dogs don't care. So it's 10:30 and I'm supposed to check out of here by 11, but I'm really getting into doing things naked. I'm making coffee naked. I only have like 15 minutes of naked and then I have to pack up and get back on the road. First time making coffee naked. Making a peanut butter sandwich naked. First time in my life making a peanut butter sandwich naked. Why is this so funny? I don't know. It's just weird. Like, when my whole life, I'm 59 years old, I never made a peanut butter sandwich naked. Make a peanut butter sandwich naked today. Probably tastes just like a regular peanut butter sandwich, fully clothed. Why is there such taboo around being naked? I don't know. Sadly, all good things come to an end, and I'm fully clothed. It's checkout time. I have 10 minutes to unhook and check out. But I'll show you the beautiful view out our back door. Very pretty out here, huh? It's time to get back on the road. I really enjoyed my time here. It was different, and it was something that I had a little apprehension doing. It's interesting that I was the only person here with the hosts. Probably the dynamics would have been different if there were other people here, but I wouldn't be able to film as much. So I think it worked out, but I'll probably be back. Like, this experience, I really liked it. And thank you to my hosts. They were wonderful. Beautiful property. Definitely be back. So it's time to end this vlog, and I'm getting on the road. See you in the next one.